Over the course of this project, we've had to learn a lot about cars and electronics. That means a lot of checking forums, watching how-to videos, and trial and error. In today's video, we'll be attempting to diagnose and repair a mechanical component.
To move on with this project in the winter without getting in Jason's way in his garage especially, which is not heated, we're gonna haul the motor to my place. Also, we've got a new back seat. Very safe. Also, the Acty seems to have developed a little bit of an exhaust problem. It got way louder yesterday, so I gotta figure that out. I had to move all my kidnapping victims to the shed to give the motor a new home. We put the Acty up on stands. We've got a couple jobs to do figuring out the suspension problem. We think the alignment's bad because both tires have worn pretty heavily on the inside. And also the exhaust system probably has a hole in it or something. The first time the Acty's been up on stands and the first time we're really gonna get under it.
We have a leak in the muffler.
We are trying as hard as we can to get ourselves covered in oxide.
That sounds pretty broken. We've diagnosed the exhaust problem. The alignment clearly needs some work. Look at these front tires. They're severely worn only on the inside, which means the alignment's bad. This is probably why I've been getting a lot of wobble. Done a little research, and we are just gonna go ahead and take the tie rod off of the center arm here. Just check the ball joint and see how it is. Right off there?
No.
Okay. Well, these are the torture instruments that we're going to use today. Oh, I like this one. If you just cover this up, it becomes the ball remover. Because this is much looser than this. This joint probably needs to be replaced. We're pretty sure we need a new center arm. This one, they want $68 in shipping and $24 in tax. It's almost 400 bucks. So we have this other site which gave us this nice diagram. First of all, you need to please order in advance. So you're not allowed to get the thing before ordering it. Then it says we can get this one for $206.75. Okay, so it says checkout complete, but I didn't actually pay any money. It says it's pending approval. Gotta wait for them to tell me whether or not they have the part. I didn't catch it on video, but it said we have an 82% chance of part availability. All the way from Japan, our new steering control arm. Oh shit, it's a box. There was a box inside the box. Nothing Dale Earnhardt can't help us out with. Got our chunk of metal from Japan. We're going to start the process, getting the tie rods off of the old part, getting the old part off and putting this on. And then we'll have nice tight steering.
Breathe that Japan air in.
Not just that, but...
Oh, it really actually does smell.
A genuine example of a part that is probably not a whole lot of these left, and they're never going to make more.
Flux capacitor looking ass thing. The Acty is so small and so light that when Jason works under it, it like wobbles.
Giving Tom some mechanic lessons.
Sorry.
So yeah, Tom, if you need to apply some force, don't worry. This thing's up on stands pretty well. We've got fail safes in place. This is one of the better vehicles to fall on you.
If you're gonna have a vehicle fall on you, you want to make it an act.
The logo of it being like a guy who's like sticking half out from under it going like.
You're gonna have one part of the tool kind of contacting that bolt and the other part above it. I think you're going the wrong way.
I'm upside down, you're right.
So you're going to tighten it just slowly. It'll eventually get really hard to turn it, at which point we're going to want to like tap the joint and see if it wants to pop apart.
I got it on there like the moment you walked away and stopped recording.
That's fine. I've already seen Jason do it too.
I know, but I didn't do it on video.
So are you feeling some tension on it yet?
Yeah, it's definitely gripping it.
Last time, didn't it kind of like pop off all of a sudden and fall down?
Yeah, that might happen. That might happen.
Which part might fall? Oh, this might fall on my head?
The whole thing, yeah. It's kind of an awkward spot to tap.
Can't get over all the videos we watched on how to do this. Now you get out your hammer! I could get the sledgehammer. That one seems like it's a bit harder than the last one, hey?
Yeah.
There we go.
Jesus!
I'm still recovering from the shock of the Acty's ass firing a gun at me.
Every mechanic watching this and like rolling their eyes at all the various ways I'm like almost dying here, just know I appreciate and love you.
Another thing I can say now, having done this, is like in horror movies when they're like about to touch the creepy gelatinous alien egg thing, and you're like, I would never touch that. Well, I just like did that. I'm like, ooh, I wonder what this is. And then put my hand right on a big glob of grease.
We gotta get this big ass nut off. It's in this recess, so we don't have a socket big enough to take care of it.
Let's see if I can see it.
This is just gonna be like that screwdriver. Eventually we're just gonna figure it out all of a sudden.
Hacksaw would do it.
Window shopping at the man's store.
We could get an adapter for that.
Our big brain geniuses did not measure it before we came here.
We left for the auto parts store before we actually knew what size socket we needed. So we just bought all the ones that were kind of close to the right size. With the understanding that because I work there part-time, we can just return whatever we don't use.
PB Blaster, so known because it's made of peanut butter.
Did I interrupt us getting it right? Yes, I was. Well, because I sat down and then like my bowels compressed.
No, we need to hit that with a solvent or something. It's not going anywhere.
Pee-pee blast?
No.
The car is taking a piss.
Frothy discharge. Really hard on it.
Is there anything we could do to obtain more leverage? Is that what that's fucking for?
Nope.
There's really very few problems that can't be fixed with one of the basic machines.
We got that nut off.
Yes, but what about the car?
Oh, no, I'm getting to experience all this lovely grease.
That is fucked, right? The thing is, see how much easier this is to move than this one? That was our problem.
That's a bad ball joint. And I do wonder, though, if this part doesn't have some kind of salvage value. We could try putting it on a forum. Although, if it's bad, then it probably doesn't.
Maybe there's people with low standards.
I want to die.
I mean, even if we didn't finish the conversion, at this point we put, what, like $500 of value into this thing?
Yeah.
Is the socket around
and
you
then
talk?
Also driven?
Yeah, sorry,
more than that out of it.
Oh, yeah, but, you know.
Because I've driven a good 10,000 K since I bought it.
Well, I'll edit that out of the video.
In case any prospective
buyers. I actually think this channel is like a major impediment to selling this vehicle.
Yeah, for sure. I'm gonna buy a video that these three assholes worked on.
You're clear.
Feels good.
It's moving freely.
Yep. Okay.
One, that was too far. Two, stop.
About there?
Yeah.
Great.
I've got a very dramatic angle on you. Looks like a documentary about cave diving or something.
Or Sandra Bullock space movie.
Oh, Gravity. Yeah. It'll look like Gravity if it goes like, I went to film school.
How much are you supposed to tighten these down? Because I don't want to compress the boot more than we have to.
Or we should. But I'd say get it to somewhere that's relatively well formed. It still lines up the cotter pack, right? So we just need to find something to make out of all the shit that we get, because to get like two of something, you have to order 500 of them.
Well, by the end, we'll be able to build a whole second Acty. Like the way they had enough parts left over after they made the space shuttle so that they could make another space shuttle. We're going to test the steering wheel. We still need to fix the alignment, and we need to decide if we want to bother repairing the muffler, since the conversion will remove it anyway, but we're really happy with this result, and the car is safer. Speaking of safety, about a month after we bought the Acty, some US states started issuing moratoria on titles for mini trucks, making new titles difficult to obtain. The reasoning is supposedly about safety, but other old cars with comparable or worse crash ratings are exempt. It's not clear what's motivating this anti-K truck crackdown, but it sucks, and we'd like to see DMVs stop doing it. One thing that would make small cars safer is having fewer ridiculous large cars on the road. I wish Americans talked as much about reducing vehicle sizes as we do about EVs, but once we enshrine something in our wasteful culture, it becomes a new standard we toil to preserve. We make electric F-150s and electric Hummers instead of asking whether we need these things at all. People should be able to buy something small, efficient, and simple instead of being forced into a set of bad choices that are big, complex, and sometimes inefficient. Show your love of mini trucks with a sticker from our store. We also have a GoFundMe. The links are in the description. And check back for more videos in 2022.